So much love to share.
Pure blackness, oneness, so rare.
So much love to care.
Let them know they're missing out. Mama Africa has
so much love to share.
Sweet blackness, oneness, be there.
So much love to care.
Let them know they're missing out. Sing again.
Hey.
For all the love and the life took away.
F.
Don't forget we were bought and traded. Ripped from the land and shipped away. Is the inspiration we use to survive.
See.
You have to see it with your own cries.
A.
Don't play add it up in a rhyme.
They call this the African massage.
Massage.
I'm sure you can tell why.
Welcome to Ichumbi.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you very much. What type of juice is this?
It's a cocktail juice.
Yeah, the juice is good. Heading towards the room. The tit room.
In the community, we shall visit the local Bachiga people. Who were joined by the Batwa Pygmies after the eviction in 1991. The Bachiga do different activities of farming and also depend on tourism as their economic, for both economic and other activities for their home. We shall get more information about the agricultural activities, and we shall also visit the community of the Batwa, the Pygmies people, look at their culture, see their medicine of herbs, because they didn't have access to medical shops. So they used nature to treat or protect themselves from different things.
We're going to check out the community.
Agandi means how are you? Then Nije means I am okay. So one of the kids has a chameleon.
Agandi.
Agandi.
Oh, this is the horned chameleon.
Yeah, the three-horned chameleon. This town is Rushaga Trading Center. People who grow different crops and have some want to sell the surplus. Old men who are talented in carving do carve different corridors, and women also do the weaving. So they also have craft shops over there where they do. All these is joined together to make a trading center where both. Also, there are also pubs where the people of the community come to chill late in the evening. So we shall stop here.
Okay.
Then go to the community of the pub.
So we've entered the community of the Bachiga tribe, and now we're gonna go to the center where the settlement of the Batwa tribe is. The indigenous people of Africa.
Here in Uganda, there are some families that are polygamous families. Mm-hmm. You find a husband has more than one wife, and all else, some wives, where you find some of their husbands died, or some other families have their husbands, and they cannot, like I told you about vulnerability. Not being able to participate or to provide fully for their families. Mm-hmm. So to eradicate all this, women try to bring themselves together so that they can build themselves and have a common goal. They can do some crafts. When you either buy a craft from them, you are supporting them to either have a book and a pen for their child. They do also entertainment, do the music, dances and drama. You can enjoy their dances.
This group is called Rushaga Community Women's Group. Yeah, we do weaving. We grow some vegetables like cabbages, spinach, and etc. So we do entertainment. Yeah, we are here to entertain for you.
Community itawanire! Community itawanire!
Yeah.
Godfrey.
Nice to meet you, Godfrey.
Hi, Godfrey.
Welcome. A teacher of this school, which is the Rushaga Community School. This one is a private school. We pay school fees.
Mm-hmm.
And here we are catering three categories of children. One is Batwa children. Do you know Batwa?
Yeah, we heard.
Okay. Then orphans. Some of they are single, others double orphans. And children with both parents. Here we have a dormitory for boys and another one for girls. Down there, even we have the kitchen where we prepare food for them, especially these orphans. For them, they live here. Because of COVID, some of the teachers disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they changed activities. That's why we are with future teachers. They are not enough.
About to enter the classroom of their school.
Welcome, dear teachers. This is primary 5 class. Feel at home and feel comfortable. We have a call for you about as the national game park. As the national game park, you see many animals, big and small, fast and slow. The elephant is the biggest. The pop is the smallest, the giraffe is the tallest, and the hyena is the ugliest.
Hello.
This is primary 6 class. Take a seat, boys and girls. You are welcome, dear visitors.
Thank you, guys.
Welcome.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Why are you happy?
Because
you see the visitors.
Yes.
Me?
No.
Oh. Yeah, they are happy because of you, but not me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you are the visitors, which means you are friendly to them now. So meaning that they are ready to interact with you.
Of course.
Okay.
If you need anything, let me know. What are they learning here? English as well?
Yeah, they're discussing.
Discussing.
Discussion.
What's the discussion about?
European explorer. This one is social studies.
Social studies.
Yeah. So the name, the question name of the European explorers who formed
the shortest
route
to India.
To India. So that's called the
camp. This is primary 7 class.
How are you guys today? You look very sad. Bad day today?
It's because here, this class, I told you that this is the highest level that we have. They are to deal with the exams and they are ready to sit for promotional exam countrywide.
Mm-hmm.
Which means this. During the night, they have to sit really hard, which means it's a difficult. They are ready to sleep, but because here we are teaching them, they are tired. In other words,
okay,
they are tired. That's why.
Good luck on your exams.
Hello,
Agandi.
Yeah.
Hi.
Yeah. Now. This is baby class, children of 3 to 4 years.
Okay.
Very small, and see the teacher teaching them numbers.
Numbers.
And teaching this class is not a simple thing, because a teacher will be able to help them how to handle a pencil, even how to use books.
Thank you. This is basically primary school, or 3 to 4 years old.
This kind of books, here in Uganda we don't have them.
Mm-hmm.
But the people, as they come in, some people used to come with the heart of our school, so they used to say that, hey, teacher, I have a small thing, get it. But they say when they go back to their area, they have used the books. I told you that they used to help our school according to their wish and according to their capability. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
According to their heart. how they feel to help our school.
All the people were staying in such houses. And it was of recent, in almost in 2015. Up to 2015, most of the people were staying in such houses.
Yes.
Kandi warabaraga besete za buri muntu nango babaga bijire kutayira
ku. Nanye kwa baramatari kuzina nanye rabagori kubireba.
Kweli?
Nanye banyura wange basema ko
she is smoking, she is smoking tobacco.
What's she gonna cook?
She ori kuteka ki? To potatoes.
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 So
these are potatoes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
A continuation about the housing structures. This bat was stayed in grass.
Agandi.
In grass-touched houses. So, and she's one of the old ladies of this community. She's 98 years. 98 years. She has stayed in the forest. She has a lot of information within the forest experience. She also experienced the community. She has stayed in this house for over 16 years.
Oh.
When it is this way, they are just renovating it, putting another pool, or putting another grass. Some tourists came when it was raining and it was flooding, like you asked. And then they donated for her a mattress where she's sleeping now.
We're going to learn now how they make fire by rubbing sticks and about the herbal medicine in a bit. Since they don't have any medications or pharmacies or anything here, they have to rely on natural remedies from the forest. They're going to also entertain us as well.
They would make fire in front of either a dead fallen tree where they want to sleep or in front of a cave, so that when it is at night and maybe a wild animal would want to sleep in that same cave, it will understand there is someone who is there. They will give us a welcoming song, and then after a welcoming song we shall have more information, learn about the medicinal herbs. Like I told you, these people didn't have access to medical shops.
Mm-hmm.
They used the nature to treat themselves. So she explains in her language, this is Omumbia, Omumbia.
Mm-hmm.
And in English it is called stinging nettle.
And what does it help treat this?
This one will help to increase the eyesight.
Okay.
Eyesight.
Okay.
Yeah. They want their sight to be strong or to look very far. So this one in her language is called H. Flamende. In English it is called Scobias.
Okay.
Scobias. Scobias acts as iodine. And to use it, someone either has has gotten a fresh wound, a fresh bleeding wound, they would get part of it, scratch it this way, and then get the juice from it, then place it on that open wound.
Okay.
Then the juice will help the blood to clot.